cause injury, because I work with companies that operate sealers that seal vinyl tubing and that sort of thing. Use radios to do that, and facilities that operate broadcast transmitters. That's where there's potentially a strong amount of radio frequency energy that, like too much sunlight, can cause injury to a human being. So what we do is we, with these safety standards, we establish not only the limit that is certain for not causing injury, but a factor of safety beyond that, so that we're sure that members of the general public don't get close enough to any of these facilities to reach that level that they get for the radio frequency equivalent of somewhere. Yes?
Do the radio waves interfere with anything else? For instance, if I was standing at a bus stop talking on my cell phone just underneath one of these nodes, would you interfere with my service from another carrier because you're so close?
No, and the reason is the closeness is offset by the fact that these distributed antenna system nodes operate at very low power because they don't need to reach far. They only need to reach maybe a quarter mile.
There's no interference.
I have a few other questions. One of them is there was an environmental justice argument made here that you're concentrating these in the core section of town.
Yeah.
The distribution of 168 throughout the city, what is the distribution that you have sort of breakdown on that?
We do have a breakdown.
Which section of the block is going to Auburn, and we go to the demographic of that's not burning, and we go to the demographic of Yonkers.
Again, we cannot address what's happening in the Bronx because another vendor
is providing. I was trying to make my point of where do you know, what do you think is going to go?
I can speak generally to that in a little bit. Wireless companies, whether they're using a traditional macro site where they put a bunch of antennas on the roof of a tall building, or if it's a place where there aren't tall buildings, they put a tower. Or it's a distributed antenna system where there are many low-power antennas on utility poles instead of a big site. These facilities are all designed to serve the population. So if you have more population, you need more cell sites. You don't need more power, you need more channels. So even those cell sites that are on the roofs of buildings in densely populated areas are putting out more power because they don't have to go very far because there's another cell site nearby. So what happens is you end up with this sort of average level so that every cell phone gets, every cell phone gets 3 or 4 bars, maybe 5 bars, and no matter what company it's using. And those bars actually represent very, very low signal strengths. It's really, when you compare it to the background energy of radio energy in the environment, we've had TV stations for generations. Radio broadcasts and other things that if we sit in this room today and turn on a radio receiver, we can pick up all kinds of signals that are on the radio waves. What the wireless communications do is it just adds to that background. They're not like a high power broadcast station in your background. Very low power. It's pretty much depending on the walk and talk. So yes,
the specific numbers.
We do. The entire network throughout the city of Yonkers, as we mentioned earlier, is 168 nodes. We try our best to break those down into individual council districts. And each one of those were listed out on an address list, and I believe those were provided to you, and I'm going to go through those right now. Council District number 1, there are 21 nodes throughout the entire first district. Council District 2, 23 nodes. No, 23. In Council District 3, 18. Council District 4, 31 nodes. Council District 5, there are 33 nodes. And Council District 6, there are 42, and that's obviously because of the geographic area.
Can I just
point
it out? So, if I could just sum it up for Solani a second. There's 168 nodes. We are assured there is absolutely no health threat. Right?
That's correct.
Creates competition. Competition is healthy. It offers a lower rate and it helps people in the community. Federally regulated, we cannot stop it anyway. And it's a benefit to the city, that's what you're telling us.
And we have 62 on the west side.
I'm pardon?
And we have 62 of them on the west side.
62 on the west side.
Yeah, 62
on the east side.
When you look at the breakdown, you have to consider a number of factors. In addition to the population density, you have to also look at the topography in the area and the tree cover. In a flat, treeless area, that facility will obviously perform a lot better than it will, say, around a corner of a large tree down a hill. So you will have, in some instances, higher concentration, not only because of the population density, but also the topography, which you clearly have around the downtown. But if I may make one more statement in addition to your comment, the system that we're proposing can accommodate multiple technologies. So even though we're looking at a seemingly significant number of nodes, this network will cover the entire city and can accommodate not only wireless technologies that are in your market today, but also can accommodate future technologies that, frankly, we might not even be talking about right now. So you would not have additional proliferation of antennas because the system can accommodate multiple carriers. So there's an additional benefit there. And once the system is in place, additional carriers can go on that system, whether they choose the whole network or if they can choose certain areas that can do that, we can accommodate
that. One of the things I had asked for, and we didn't get it in time, was the number of antennas around the entire city, so that we could get a breakdown of it. I do know that it's a large concentration. So all of us, we're only talking about 62 on the west side, and 62 people that's already here. And that's my point.
And now we have to come from your planning department. We have to go ahead and
get that. And what do we have next time?
We have more.
Yeah, but the most thing. Yeah. And the most time will go once again on the west side.
My hope is that something like this, this technology, will make those two antennas. That's it, no more? Or could you come back and say we have to increase? If we had another, if there was another carrier, for instance, Verizon, who wanted to come in and use a DAS network here in Yonkers, and to use our network, our 168 nodes or our fibers laid out in space, if they wanted a little bit more coverage or different coverage, might need the fiber to go in a different direction, and we might need to use a few utility poles that we're not moving currently beyond, then there could be a few.
Well, then how many carriers can each node handle?
We can handle, I think the better way to answer the question is not how many can each node handle, but how many carriers can this type of a network handle within the city? And like Tim was saying, all of the carriers could run on this network.
But why then would you need to add additional?
Because
the way you're putting them, you're installing them now, you give the city ample coverage. So why would Verizon or somebody else need to go and run a cable somewhere, fiber optic somewhere else?
I think that's an excellent question. First and foremost, the system that we're proposing is for a new carrier entrant to the New York market that has no existing facilities. So in order for them to compete and comply with the objectives of their federal license, they are mandated to provide coverage to as many citizens as possible within a geographical area. So the system that we're proposing right here is for Metro PCS. Now, if Verizon or Sprint or anyone else were to come on the system, they would have, obviously, the benefit of their existing facilities that you folks see and we were talking about a minute ago. If an additional facility were to be needed, it may not be a coverage need, it could be a capacity issue. And as we all know, our phones are doing more and more nowadays. Unfortunately, my phone doesn't, but you folks probably have nice phones that can download substantial amounts of data, and that may be a reason for a carrier to select a location where we may not have a facility, but because of customer demand, they need to bolster perhaps an intersection or something of that nature. So it's very old.
How does that go towards the agreement for the agreements for 168? Do you have to come back and renegotiate?
The agreement is not necessarily based, and I don't want to speak for the legal folks, it's not based on